I'll tell you how it was starting out a ways back. We first put our band together, a three-piece band, Delaware Destroyers, Jeff Simon, Ron Smith, and myself. We played enough gigs, not too many, but enough to know that we got a very good reaction out of the people watching. Good response that encouraged us to say, I think we can do this. But again, we had no record deal, no manager, no agent, anything like that. So we were pretty much on our own. We needed a record, we didn't have one. So we took any gig we could get. So I found out there was a place, the Newark School for the Deaf, in Newark, Delaware. I said, I can get us a gig there. And the guys in the band looked at me like, Thorogood, the School for the Deaf. I said, yeah. They call it School for the Deaf, but they're not deaf people. They were hearing impaired. And they said, well, how much are you getting paid? And I said, well, nothing. No, it'll be great. You know, we need a PA system. We got no PA system. Here's what's gonna happen. We're gonna play the gig, and a miracle's gonna happen. We'll play so great that one of the kids will hear for the first time, and it'll be our music. And one of these rich high rollers will come up to us in tears saying, you know, my kid heard music for the first time. Here's the check. I heard you boys need a PA system. And the guys look at me and go, Thorogood, you've seen too many movies. And I'm like, no, this is gonna work. Would you trust me on this? All right. Okay. They're gonna do it, but they just like having fun with me. So we do it. We get down there and play, set up and play. It was pretty much a cafeteria, and they had a kitchen, a cafeteria. We didn't really see any of the classes. I guess that's what it was. And we, you know, set up in this on the side there. You know, when you're a musician, once you get rocking and everybody starts dancing, hey, everything's groovy. You know, say, hey, they dig us, man, they dig us. So that was a big rush for us. And it really was fantastic. Thinking of what, if it was a success, yes, it was, because the kids loved it. They put their hands on the drum riser, and they feel the beat, and they dance to that. Or they even touch your guitar, and it could feel the vibration. They're dancing all over the place, you know, talking their language, they talk. And sometimes they'd look at us and be laughing, and I was thinking, are they making fun of us? And I said, they probably are, you know, but they had fun. So show's over, breaking down the equipment. A lady comes up to us, and really happy woman, real happy. That was wonderful, you guys. You boys are just, oh, you played so good, oh, man. I'm looking at the guys in the band, I'm going, here it is. Here comes the checkbook, I know it. And ladies, I want to do something for you fellas. I said, yeah, and she goes, fellas, there's cookies and cokes in the kitchen. Well, to a lot of rock acts, cookies and coke meant a whole lot different than cola and chocolate chip, okay? So that's what really made us laugh. The best cookies and coke we ever ate. So now to this day, when we go play a gig and it looks kind of, Jeff Simon look at me and say, there's cookies and cokes in the kitchen. The Delaware Destroyers, band to the bone, bourbon, scotch, and beer, and we're eating mommy's cookies. Sometimes your reputation follows you. So there you have it. Get drunk, don't you have no fear. I want